What's your athletic budget?
It's over 200 million. It's probably 220, 225 in that range.
Where does that put you in the U.S.?
Depending on how you count, probably first.
And that's without a winning football team of late.
It's in spite of our football team. We've been winning, just not like we like to win.
3-7 against the Horned Frogs. Maybe your fan base would rather lose to Alabama than TCU. So
I just can't quit you, Big 12 drama. I just can't. Did you just hear that just now? Oh my God. That happened yesterday. The Texas State Senate wasted government dollars on the state level at Texas to have a conversation with Jay Hartzell, University of Texas president, who hasn't had the job for a year yet. And he got Bob Bowlesby right behind. Just look at this. Look at this. Bob Bowlesby right behind him. Just like, you know, just staring, just like burning through the back of his head with that stare. Oh, he is so mad. Big mad today. But this little, like, the Texas State Senate, like, hosting Big 12 divorce court, it is, last night was better than Monday Night Raw 1998 with Stone Cold and Vince McMahon. It was beautiful. My only wish was that some way Oklahoma and Oklahoma State could all have been a part of this, but you know what? I'll take what I can get here. They went through the whole process, and I was wondering if Jay Hartzell was about to say, "Your Honor, West Virginia and TCU aren't even my biological children." I can't. But now, as we move into Tuesday, there is now word leaking out that Bob Bowlesby is going to do everything he can to beg and plead with the Pac-12 to set up some sort of, at minimum, a scheduling alliance with the Pac-12. Maybe a merger, but I don't know how much of in a hurry the Pac-12 is, because unlike the Big 12 remaining schools, they're probably going to have options, because they could do something with the Big 12, or if, like, all the other reports are saying are true, they could do something with the Big 10, and they have a partnership already with them that's tied to the Rose Bowl. And we all know the Rose Bowl likes to decide the fate of college football more times than not, because we're so attached to it for some reason more than we should, although it's a great atmosphere, great game. But the point of the matter is that Pac-12 is going to have options. So where do you go from here? It's like, I stand pat on everything I've been saying on here, on Twitter, wherever you hear me talk. If you're a Big 12 school with multiple options and you can get in on your own to the ACC or the Big 10, you better take that as soon as possible. But on the other hand, there's going to be some schools who want to have, who their best hope is a package deal. It's like, hey, no one's going to want Baylor by themselves. But if you package them together with TCU and Texas Tech and, you know, all that stuff, and Oklahoma State and maybe K-State, and, you know, maybe, you know, it's like, it's kind of like when you get the loser candy at Halloween. It's not the brand name, it's the off-brand candy. It's like, what the heck is this stuff? It's still candy, but, you know, there's usually one or two pieces out in the inner that are not too bad, so you kind of make it work. But, yeah, overall, this is something else that I've come to a realization, and that for all of us out there, including Texas fans, you should be really thrilled about. I am so happy that when this news broke, that it was a signed, sealed, and delivered deal for the most part 9 days after the fact. News broke on a Wednesday. The next Friday, we're in the SEC. Whether it's 2025 or next year, it's going to happen. The decisions have been made. Paperwork has been signed. Great news. You don't have to deal with months or even years of speculation and misleading or false reports or rumors or innuendo. You don't have to deal with any of that crap. We don't have to put up with that. It's great. So, again, good luck to the rest of the Big 12 schools, as I said, but man, that stuff last night was so great. Like that clip, I will treasure that clip for the rest of time as much as you know, Texas losing to the Jayhawks a few years back, almost as much as that. But Paulsby just like, you know, staring laser beams into the back of his head like that. Oh, just, but Paulsby quoting, talking about how, you know, he didn't know, you know, he had no idea this was coming. And, you know, but what has to be one of my favorite quotes from this thing is from this Texas State Senator, Charles Perry, who addressed as the Jay Hartzell, the UT president. You know, if you're as big and great as you think you are, you should have made the Big 12 equal or better than the SEC. You didn't do it. This is one of those times where you can tell people to seriously stick to politics because you have no idea what you're talking about. Oh, man, it's just been a wonderful ride. I cannot, I just can't appreciate this. As you have no idea how much I appreciate this and all how hilarious this is to all of us right now. But with that being said, camp opens up later this week. It's kind of just kind of what we're sitting around waiting for to hear some news about that. But, yeah. Hopefully we'll hear some good stuff. I mean, we've already heard some good stuff from summer workouts, but we're just ticking down to football, you know, watching the clock, patiently, hoping to get there sooner than later. Anyway, you'll have a good one, Boomer Sooner. I'm out.